Hello, welcome back to another Netflix series review, The Lava Field. It's another European production. I believe it's Iceland. Once again, it's fit in my wheelhouse as far as murder, mystery, crime genre. My favorite as far as serial TV. The actors in this series, I'm not familiar. You know, one of the things I like about watching foreign-made series, whether it's Brazil or Iceland or the UK, is that I get exposed to a lot more talents that I normally don't see. And I felt that for the most part, the acting in this series was okay. Perhaps the biggest complaint I have is the female chief, the chief of police. I thought she was not well written and not well acted. That's my, I think my biggest complaint as far as acting wise. This is a spoiler filled discussion. So be warned that there will be spoilers here. This series is only 4 episodes, okay? And compare it to The Break. I review The Break. For those that haven't seen my review for The Break, I was trying to put a link somewhere here so that you can see my review and opinions on The Break. This is almost the opposite of The Break. It's 4 episodes, and the way the story was built around the drug smuggling, money laundering, biker gangs, I felt that there was a lot more they could have done to expand the series before 4 episodes, because unlike The Break, where there was too many misdirection, this one, there was not that many misdirections. So it was not a whole lot of mystery to be solved. It's very tough to give a rating for this one. For those that are not familiar with my rating, 8 and above out of 10 is highly recommended, must see. 6 and 7 tend to be proceed with caution. If it might not be for everyone. If you don't have a lot of time to waste, you might not want to allocate too much time to watch the show. 5 and below is avoid, okay? I'm tempted. Okay, this one is barely above 5. I give it a weak 6, okay? The problem with the show, the highlight of the show, believe it or not, is not the story, not the acting, but the scenery. My God, what a beautiful backdrop that they use. I'm not familiar with Iceland whatsoever, and I can tell you, wow. Why hasn't Hollywood used Iceland as a location for science fiction movies or TV shows? I don't know, but the lava field itself is gorgeous, beautiful. Like, it's like you live in a different planet. It's something that I have not seen or familiar with. So a big thank you for the show to at least expose me to the elements that I'm not familiar and have never seen. So that being said, if that is the best part of the show, there is a big problem with the story. I felt that the story was not well done from the very first episode. I was hoping and hoping and hoping that somehow things would get better, and it did not. The murder scenes from the get-go, seriously, why would you make that into such a sloppy mess so that the so-called suicide is just a laughable concept? You can't have a house ransacked, window shot at, and then have the guy commit suicide, or the killer trying to make it look like he commits suicide. It's just silly. That premise was so silly, in my opinion. And as in many crime, murder, mystery, when you have what make many crime mystery interesting is the mystery, or a combination of the mystery and the cunning perpetrators that can try to escape being caught or trying to have the police look in the wrong direction. In this show, there was none of that. You have, you know, a bumbling bunch of bikers that are responsible, and I don't think they were well portrayed. They portrayed as a bunch of bullies and idiots. That's not to blame the actors. You know, the actors do what the actors have to do, but as far as the writing, I think this in this show, I blame much of the problem on the writing, because when you create a crime mystery with bumbling, stumbling idiots, and there was not much to a mystery as far as a crime, it makes for a so-so story. I mean, the four episodes, like I said, it was not hard to binge through the four episodes. I believe each episode is like 45 minutes, but it was not all of that intrigue as far as I'm concerned. You know, that's where you know, I give this one a low rating. You know, like I said, I want people to see it more because I want people to see the landscape and the backdrop of Iceland that most of us have not been exposed to. And the acting was okay for the most part. It just not well written, in my opinion. And that's my review for The Lava Field. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.